हेलो चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू लेसन नंबर 7। दैट इज योर पोएम एंड द नेम ऑफ द पोएम इज अ चाइल्ड्स थॉट। सो चिल्ड्रन, कैन यू सी द पिक्चर्स गिवन इन दिस पोएम? अ चाइल्ड इज स्लीपिंग एंड ही इज हैविंग अ ड्रीम, एंड इन हिज ड्रीम ही इज जस्ट इन हिज इमेजिनेटिव वर्ल्ड। He's just in the swimming. He's swimming in the splendor, lost in that imagination. So let's begin this poem. A child's thought, and the name of the poet is Robert Louis Stevenson. He was born in 1850, and he died in 1894. He was a Scottish novelist, poet, and travel writer. He wrote books for children. His popular books are Trailland and Kidnapped, and his collection of poems for children, A Child's Garden of Verses, is well liked by children as well as adults too. So Robert Louis Stevenson, he is a well known poet. Let's begin. At 7 when I go to bed, I find such pictures in my head. Castles with dragons sprawling round, gardens where magic fruits are found. Fair ladies present in a tower, or lost in an enchanted bower. While gallant horsemen ride by streams, that border all this land of dreams. I find so clearly in my head, at 7 when I go to bed. So children, here in this first stanza, the poet has shown the emotions of a child who sleeps and dreams of wonderful imaginative vividness, like castles, dragons and garden. Now he expresses the feelings of a child when he sleeps, and when he wakes up, he noticed that it was not reality, and his real world is far less understanding than in his dream world. Okay, so the child, he is lost in that imagination. He is swimming in the splendor, beautiful adventure, and let's read one by one. I'll explain you these lines. So at 7 when I go to bed. Now children, it's very early to go to bed at 7 in the evening, but here it seems that child is very small, and it's a appropriate time to sleep. So he says, at 7 when I go to bed, when I sleep at 7, I find such pictures in my head. Now, when he sleeps and he finds such dream in his mind, where beautiful palaces, forts, imaginative dragons, and you can see the gardens also. So children, dragons, it is also imaginative, animated thing that breathe out fire, and he walk around the castles in search of its prey, or to eat or to burn whatever they found around. Okay, so I find such pictures means where he can see the castle, dragon, garden, fair ladies who are imprisoned in a tower. Okay, so he see gardens in his dream. He saw castles with dragons. They are prowling round, means they are moving here and there in search of its prey. And forts he can see, beautiful forts and palaces he can see. These all pictures are in his mind. Gardens where magic fruits are found. Now gardens in his dream consists of golden fruits, which he thinks that he will eat and become strong and bigger. And these magic fruits are golden and silver, just imagining those fruits. And fair lady is prisoned in a tower. You know that, children, in the stories you must have read that a beautiful princess, they are imprisoned in the tower by their parents or any other person, and they are imprisoned, and then the prince, he will be there to rescue her, to save her, to take out her from that imprisonment. So God, fair ladies present in a tower. So beautiful ladies, they are imprisoned there and they are waiting for the prince to rescue them. Or lost in an enchanted bar. So children, bar is here is forest, and enchanted is that is spellbound, you can say. So children, they might be imprisoned or they may be lost in a forest that is spellbound, means that is under the effect of magic. So children, this child, he goes to bed at 7 and he is dreaming now. He can see pictures in his mind, in his head, and in those pictures he can see dragon, horseman, castle, tower, garden with magic fruits, and fair ladies which are imprisoned in a tower, beautiful ladies, and waiting for the prince to come and rescue them. Or they may be lost in a forest that is spellbound, which is having which is under the effect of magic. While gallant horsemen ride by streams. Now gallant horsemen here means brave soldiers, brave men, you can say here. So they do not fear dragon, they do not fear enchantment, they do not fear magic. They just ride on bravely, and there are streams all around this area where these things are, like castle, tower, dragons, horsemen, and there are streams all around. So horsemen, they are riding, they just ride bravely, they enter there, they come there, that border all this land of dreams. So this land of dreams is bordered by streams, rivers, small rivers, and these horsemen, these brave soldiers, they are just coming on their horses. I find so clearly in my head now all these pictures, they are clear, there is a clear picture in his mind of the vivid beauty and variety of dreamland. Now children, he is stressing again and again here, stressing on the poem in on these lines, at 7 when I go to bed. He is just talking when this is all in his dream when he goes to bed at 7. He can see those beautiful creatures, that phenomena, that adventures. Now let's begin the second paragraph, stanza, not paragraph, it's stanza. At 7 when I wake again, the magic land I seek in vain, a chair stands where the castle front, the carpet hides the garden ground. No fairies trip across the floor, boots and not horsemen flank the door, and where the blue streams rippling ran, is now a bath and water can. I seek the magic land in vain at 7 when I wake again. Now children, when he wakes up at 7, he had a sound sleep for that 12 hours. He was lost in his dreamland, and when he wakes up at 7 in the morning, what he notices, he come to know that magic land is gone. Whatever he wants in his dreamland is gone, and he wants that dreamland again. Vain here means futile, not having positive result, means it was not fruitful. So now see the disappointment, he's disappointed. We can see the disappointment of the child here, that he notices that the magic land I seek in vain, means the land, that magic land which he wants, he desires, that is all disappeared. Now the carpet, a chair stands where the castle from. Now the objects like castles, dragons, they are replaced by ordinary things that exist already in his room. So now he can see a chair in which is replaced in place of castle. Frowned, castle frowned means disapproving you to enter. Castle frowned means that castle which is disapproving you to enter, means a chair is there in place of castle, and the carpet hides the garden ground. Now garden is replaced by carpet. Now he can see a carpet over there. Maybe earlier it might be earlier grass over there. Now that garden is replaced by carpet. No fairies trip across the floor. Now there are no fairies that fly around, that dance around, walk around across the floor. He is not able to see now fairies dancing over there, running over there, walking over there across that floor. And boots and not horsemen flank the door. Now you see in the castles or in the palaces on the at the door, you will notice that on both the sides you can see the guards over there. Now there are no guards over there, no horsemen over there. Now we can see boots in place of horsemen that flank the door, means placed on both sides of the door. He can see the boots, not the horsemen. He cannot see the horsemen over there. And where the blue stream's rippling ran is now a bath and a water can. Now where that river, that stream, that clear blue clear river over there, that is rippling means that was making sound of the waves. Now he cannot hear those sounds and he cannot see that blue stream over there that flew with the rapid motion. Now that is not visible over there. Now that has disappeared. And in place of those blue streams, he can see his bathing tub and water bucket over there. Now that stream, that blue rippling stream, is replaced by bathing tub and water bucket over there. I seek the magic land in vain. At 7 when I wake again. Now he said that he wants to get back to that magic land. That's why he is repeating this line again and again. I seek the magic land in vain at 7 when I wake again. When I woke up in the morning at 7, I found that all the things that he saw in his dream, now they have disappeared. And the objects like castles, dragons, they are replaced by ordinary things which are in his room. So children, poet has shown the emotions of a child who sleeps and dreams of wonderful imaginative world of his own. And when he wakes up, he notices that it was not reality and your real world is far less interesting than your dream world. That's all. Thank you.